But the 400 meter hurdles, the athletes out on the track, just getting their blocks adjusted, and that's the lineup for heat one. Anna Dottir from Iceland goes in one. Debbie Paris from Jamaica in two. Taipei is represented by Pei Xin in lane three. De Angeli from Italy in four. Then the former world champion, Tania Ledevskaya, formerly of the Soviet Union, of course, now Belarus in five. Kapalu, Vanuatu in six. And then Sandra Farmer-Patrick of the United States of America goes in lane seven. And Michelle Schenk of Switzerland in the outside lane. Three will go through automatically, and four fastest losers through to the semi-finals. But there's Sandra Farmer-Patrick, one of the fastest hurdlers of all time. Second, of course, in the Olympic Games to Sally Gunnell. And who will forget Sally coming off the final hurdle, neck and neck with this athlete, and then just striding ahead to take the gold medal.
Well, Farmer-Patrick out of the World Championships last year. She didn't compete. And that left it to the other Americans. And really, it's interesting to see her compete against Gunnell and Batten and Buford. Ledevskaya, we talked about her, Paul, you mentioned her earlier. I remember when she won the world title, she ran so quickly over the first 200 meters. We thought, well, surely she's going to fade in the third 100 meters, but she didn't. She just hung on. And but since then, her form has not been quite of that ilk.
Well, certainly she hasn't run the sort of time that she won that championship with, 53.11. She hasn't bettered that since 1991. Second in the Olympic Games back in 88, and then fourth in Barcelona. So still a class athlete, but I'll be very interested to see what sort of form she has this year. Haven't seen very much of her this year at all. Certainly quite a strong heat, this one, with Debbie Paris, the Jamaican, who was third in the Commonwealth Games a couple of years ago. She's in lane two. That's Anna Dottir. Iceland producing some very good women athletes over the last couple of years. Their men have always been very strong in the throws, but Iceland have a very, very good young pole vaulter, who's also called Anna Dottir. I don't know whether that's a common name in Iceland, but tremendous prospect in the women's pole vault, which of course isn't in the Olympic Games. It probably will be in 4 years' time, and hopefully it will be in the European Championships and the Commonwealth Games in a couple of years' time. There's Tania Ledevskaya. Just outside her, very inexperienced athlete, Mary Kapalu, a world champion inside her, an Olympic silver medalist outside her. When Farmer-Patrick was running at her best, I'm sure some of you will remember the very flamboyant athletic strips she used to wear. Michelle Schenk there in lane eight. But Farmer-Patrick, I was going to say, she set the standard of fashion. I think she was the only one who had the guts to wear some of the things she was wearing. She turned up once in something that looked like a ballet dress, raised a few eyebrows. Heavily strapped left leg. Perhaps just a precaution. Normally when you see strapping like that, it means possible hamstring injuries. But here we go with heat one. Anna Dottir, Debbie Paris, Pei Xin, De Angeli of Italy, Ledevskaya, Kapalu, Farmer-Patrick, and Michelle Schenk. Well, the starter really held them for a long, long time before they went up into the set position. But they're away well. Anna Dottir going quite well in lane one. Debbie Paris, remember, just outside her. Farmer-Patrick not going terribly well down the back straight. She's being caught by Ledevskaya, who's two lanes inside her at the moment. So we'll see what Farmer Patrick's got left. But Anna Dottier and Debbie Paris going quite well in lanes one and two. Anna Dottier really running a tremendous race. 54.93 as they go through 200 meters. The Icelandic athlete has run this year. And I think she's going to come into the home straight on the lead. But what has Farmer Patrick got left now? She's well down. On the outside, it's Michelle Schenk. This would be a major shock, but I think Farmer Patrick coming through now. Anna Dottier is clear. Debbie Paris coming strongly. And Farmer Patrick is going to qualify, but it was very, very close. Anna Dottier in first place. Debbie Paris second, I think, although Farmer Patrick may have snatched it on the line. Now then, a big question mark over the American.
Well, certainly Farmer Patrick, I think, got second with Paris in third, but it really wasn't the most convincing of performances, and clearly that strapped thigh tells the story. She clearly is having a problem. She really didn't look at all sharp there. That, I don't think, is precautionary. That looks very, very heavy. And she looks to be a little bit upset to me, Paul, and I think she recognizes that the injury is not good enough. She is second, certainly, but she's not. I wonder whether we shall see her again. Farmer Patrick, distraught, and I reckon that injury is serious.
And certainly not in the mood to be interviewed by anybody at this stage. But look at Anna Dottier on the inside. The finishing time was 54.89. That is a new lifetime best, and I wouldn't be surprised at all if it's an Icelandic record. This athlete actually resident in the United States, but that was the race of her life. Farmer Patrick really came through strongly, and she did get second place ahead of Debbie Paris, but she obviously has a problem.
Yeah, it looks like a hamstring, really serious hamstring problem. I mean, that was a matter of survival for her. She had that surge at the end to qualify, and that must have hurt her considerably, and she's clearly distressed, as you can see for yourself, and I wonder whether we shall see her again.
If she was in pain, that was a very brave run. She was way, way down with about 100 meters left. Let's see her on the outside. Always anything but a neat hurdler. Tall, gangly almost. Always somebody we said had tremendous potential in this event. She was, of course, Olympic and World Championship silver medalist. But no sign of pain just at the moment. And she was focusing straight ahead, looking across there. She saw she was safe, but all the problems, all the emotion happened afterwards. And we can see the result. Gudrun Anna Dottier there, 54.88 seconds, possibly an Icelandic record, as we said. Sandra Farmer Patrick, 55.55 in second, but will she take further part in these championships? Debbie Paris of Jamaica in third place, 55.64. Michelle Schenk and the rest, and Ledevskaya, we'll have to wait and see.